this video tutorial, you'll learn how to apply a simple mixed media art method to a still life drawing. Still life means a work of art depicting mostly inanimate subject matter, typically commonplace objects which can be either natural or man-made. This video is a great activity for students who wish to explore a range of different art medias in just one drawing. This method is widely used amongst upper secondary art students to support sketchbooks and portfolios of work. This method of mixed media exploration helps to demonstrate students' skills in material exploration and can diversify or develop an image or idea very quickly. Materials you'll need are an object to use for your still life. Here I use a simple shaped flower, a small piece of brown toned paper. Here I'm using sugar paper, but you could cut a piece from a brown paper bag, envelope or cereal packet card, a piece of newspaper and some thick paper for the backing, such as sketchbook paper or cartridge paper. You will also need a pair of scissors, a glue stick, an eraser, pencil sharpener and some mixed art medias to work with. To simplify this tutorial, please refer to the following materials I use. For brown paper, we use colouring pencils. Newspaper, we use fine black pens. And for the white paper background, a simple pencil. After prepping our materials, let's begin this mixed media still life. Step 1. Cut out and glue the section of newspaper and brown tone paper or card using a glue stick. Be sure to apply the glue to all four corners of the material and away from the white paper to avoid any messy excess. Step 2. Decide on an angle view to draw your object. Outline the shape of the object over the top of your paper material background. Make sure the angle is achievable for you to draw and that you don't keep changing the object position. Step 3. Begin to fill in all the details of your still life using the materials decided on for each paper section. Here I am plotting in the black pen over the top of the newspaper before I move on to the coloured pencils over the brown section and pencil sketch over the white paper background. When using coloured pencils, if you have a white area, it's important to remember that you don't have to use an immediate black to create shadow. You can just use darker tones of one colour. So for example, where I want the darkest areas around the pink petal leaves, I actually chose a dark blue to create the shadow. When working on your still life, take your time, take a break, look at somewhere else if you get tired, and use your eyes again to rejudge what is missing or any details or shadow or pattern that is still needing to be plotted in. Here, this drawing probably took me about 30 minutes in real life, but I have sped it up just so that the video is not too long. So really have a look, use your eyes as though you were using a magnifying glass. Here you can see that I've plotted in the veins of the petals as well. I've noticed the direction of the lines. I've noticed the value, the difference between the darkness and the lightness of the petals. And I have gone over that again using a harder pressure around the edges. I'm also using my fingers here to smudge between the dark, the medium and the light. If you have a blending stump, you can use that. If you want to highlight, remember to use your eraser to add any lighter areas. And really just take your time to observe all of the details. When I took a break from this drawing, I came back and I actually noticed that there was no gradient, as you see here, from the pencil then going into the pen. So this is why here I'm starting to hatch, and I also do a little bit of cross hatching just to make a bit more of a gradual transition in gradient where I'm using my pen.